Hi there folks, welcome back to another video. Thanks for joining me here. Today is going to be kind of a short video. I just want to show you folks the bounty of all the monsoon weather and all the rain. My famous tank here is now totally full, and so that is super exciting. So if you haven't watched the video on how I created this rainwater harvesting system for my solar panels, you might want to take a look at that. But essentially what I did is there's space between the panels, and I basically put Gorilla tape over all the spaces so I collect all the water, none falls through the cracks, as they say. And then that all just drains down, the water all just drains down into the gutter, and then there's plumbing here that allows the water then to come down into the tank. So as you can see, this is where the water comes out after it's came down the gutter to fill the tank. And it's right level now. It can't get any more water in here. And so by the looks of things, folks, there's a little bit of sun peeking through, but for the most part, the big old honking clouds here are indicating we're going to get more and more rain. So naturally, I want to take advantage of every little drop of rain I'm going to get. So I'm going to take and drain water out of the tank, and I've decided I can put it over in my big tank by use of a pump. So I'll show you all that. So fortunately, I have a really long extension cord which I plugged into my Titan solar generator and ran it from the cabin, and now I'm gonna hook it up to the pump. So I think the last time I used this really cool water pump here was to clean out my pond. So that means who knows how gunky it is in here. So this rain has been so heavy that it just collected in my gorilla cart. And so I thought, well, a good use for the water here in the gorilla cart is to pump it all out, and at the same time help purge my water pump here. And I never waste water if I can help it, so I'll just run it over to my little catalpa tree, which I bought earlier this year. Which poor little thing just doesn't seem real happy here. It's being watered and cared for. I just don't know. It just doesn't like it here for some reason. So we'll plug things in and see what happens. Oops. Get some of the mud out of the plug. Always helps. So the idea is to purge the pump, and the water that's coming out of there looks pretty clean. So that means that the pump itself internally, I may have even cleaned it before I put it away, I don't know. But this way it's getting a good purge. Thought of putting vinegar in there, but I don't know, that might have affected the pump wrong. What do you folks think? Would vinegar water hurt a pump in any way? Leave it in the comments below and let me know. So in a perfect world, I would have enough hose to run all the way from the tank where I want to put this water, and I could have done a direct pump from the rainwater harvesting tank over there, which hopefully you can see underneath the solar panels, right over to my tank where I want the water to go. But I don't have long enough hose, and by the time I go to Home Depot and buy hose, the whole day is going to be wasted, so I think I'm going to haul it by hand. So naturally I could take my pump, put it in the tank, and then run the hose from the pump right into the buckets and go from there, but I've found that that's actually slower than the old manual dip method. So a bit of a quick review for those of you who are new to the channel. all the rainwater hitting my little cabin roof travels down the spout there and then travels underground. You can't see it because it's all buried through a 3-inch schedule 40 pipe. Then it comes over to my tank and spills into the 1200 gallon tank. Now, even though we've been getting a lot of rain, it takes a while for this tank to fill up. So I've still got plenty of space left in there. So rather than take this assembly apart, folks, and remove the cap, so I'm going to make use of this overflow spout with its mosquito guard on it. It'll be fun being able to put more water in my tank. So first we'll drop the pump into our bucket of clean water. All the way down, that's it. Juggling the hose, don't want to get all muddy. You just shove the hose in there, kind of like a catheter. Oops, sorry. All right, good sign, I hear water pouring in. Not going as fast as I would have hoped, but this flexible hose is so easily pinched, and you know, if I had to do it again, I'd get a much sturdier, non-flexible tubing here or hose. So what I'm doing here is I'm going to measure from this tank to my 1200 gallon tank because I think a direct tube or line from one tank to another, so I just pump from there over to my 1200 gallon tank, is going to be probably a lot less labor intensive. So it looks like we're looking at about 50 feet. So if the tubing is over $1 a foot, it's going to be a very expensive piece of equipment. So I found out there was enough room to insert the tubing from the water pump right into the tank. And the great thing is, what you can't see here is there's a screen to catch any crud that might be in the water, and that's really great. All right, in goes the water pump. Now the power. Not good. I think our pump may have given up on us. I really don't know what was wrong with the pump. I just kind of give it a bit of a shake just to kind of wake it up like it was sleeping. And now it's pumping again. I don't know. And of course, if you listen, you can hear, for me, the most magical sound here on the property, water running into the tank. So while we're talking about the abundant rain and its effect on the landscape, I thought maybe I'd give you folks a wildflower tour of the property. So a lot of these flowers I'm just learning the names of, and I have a long ways to go to learn them all. I figure if any of my subscribers are experts in desert wildflowers, they could name these for me. Leave the names in the comments below, please. Some of you folks said, hey Don, there's no way you can transplant those wildflowers, they'll die. Oh well, I'm going to give it a go anyway. Here we go. At first they look really sad and they're all bowed over and they're like, what did you do to us, Don? But in 24 hours, they'll look like their friends nearby, all nice and ready to face the sun. So guess what, folks? I just transplanted these, and I transplanted these a few days ago, and they never missed a beat. They kept flowering, and they loved their new home. So I don't know. I guess maybe they sensed I really cared for them. Is there such a thing as a flower whisperer? Does that make me maybe one of those people? Don't know. So in the last video, I believe in the comments, someone identified this species. I don't know what it is still, even though I own it. So I'd love it if you put that in the comments below, what the species is. Thanks a lot.
Some of you asked how my Chinese Empress trees are growing, or Polonia, and well, just take a look, you know, they're just getting huge, and it's just really fun to see a plant that came in a tray that big 2 months ago looking like this. So I took a good amount of water out of here, a lot of gallons, so it's now down quite a bit, so now I can prepare for our next big rainstorm. And it's always a judgment call because I didn't want to put so much in my 1200 gallon tank that the water coming from the roof of my cabin would have no place to go. And then it would just end up, there's an overflow spout, and it would just be coming out of the overflow spout. That wouldn't have been very smart. So hopefully this will balance out okay. But the main thing is there's space now for more water. Thanks so much, folks, for joining me on this video and just getting to take a look around at what all the crazy monsoon rains are doing and all the abundance of rainwater, which is fantastic. And I so appreciate you being here. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. And if you haven't hit the notification bell, hit that, and that'll let you know when my next video is coming up. And thanks so much. And as you can see, the Huachuca Mountains are totally shrouded in clouds. Looks like more rain. See you on the next video.